It's not a fee. It's not a fee. It's actually just the cost of transmitting this material. There are no financial benefits.
Absolutely.
And we're happy. Look, we look forward to the facts coming out.
The per item thing works a little better just because we can see how much we can get out of it. Because if you have someone in a really anti-state that's going to be doing this for you, they're probably going to get caught. But up to 25 patients a day. Obviously not all in the gestational age that you're interested in. But you want mostly over 14s?
Yeah. You can kind of play with that lower range, I think, if the specimens are coming out more intact. And so that, I mean, I guess we'll kind of get a first-hand look at that today, later on. How many procedures are scheduled
to... Can I interrupt just right there when you're talking about an intact specimen? So how many of those do you see?
An intact specimen?
Within. So what's your volume in on an average Tuesday?
With just second tries?
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe five. So anywhere as low as 3 up to 7.
Okay. All right. And so intact? Can
intact. So we do basically DNEs. Intact is probably less than 10%.
Less than 10%.
Sometimes, you know, if someone delivers before we are able to see them for procedure, then we are intact.
But you'll never know.
That's not what we go for.
Yeah.
We try for that to not happen. If someone delivers before we are able to see them for procedure, then we are intact.
So obviously we want product that we can use.
Yep.
That's,
I think that's probably the biggest thing is that we want to avoid paying for material that we're not going to be able to process and use and send to researchers. So if there's, you know, we certainly see a difference between, it makes a big difference to us if there's a case that is, you know, so mangled we can't even get like a shred of, you know, piece of liver out of it versus something that we can get, you know, we can get liver, thymus, pancreas, and neural tissue.
So
obviously that second case is a lot more...
compensation could be specific to the specimen.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And I think then we would just, I mean, I think for us, we would need criteria.
Yeah, clear criteria.
For what makes something
usable or not.
Okay.
Right.
And even if you have pictures, because I think some of it is visual, at least at this level.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because we're not able to, and we're not looking at things under the microscope to be able to see if it's usable or not.
Right.
So this is going to be naked eye. Determination, and so those kinds of things of what you're looking for. Obviously, you'd get trained. I don't know if I've ever seen a thymus, but maybe I haven't. I don't know. I know I've seen livers, I've seen stomachs, I've seen plenty of neural tissue. We usually, you can see the whole brain usually come out.
Uh-huh.
You know, when you get to 17, 18 weeks, because we do some of those, and that's when you're doing a lot more of the DNA, and you might get larger. So that's where we have to do a little bit of training with the providers on making sure they didn't crush or... we're able to.
So it's a matter of just training, it sounds like, to a provider.
I think so. I mean, it's hard to know how their specimens come out right now, because it's not like we've ever been looking.
It's not your,
We haven't been looking, so it's, we have to kind of see the baseline of how things are getting extracted now, and then see if we could do any work with them to maybe be a little bit more gentle. So I feel like if you're talking to other plant parents, we sort of all have to be on the same almost to the point where we have to disclose to each other that we're all doing this. So if anyone gets called out or runs with it, that we're all like, oh, I didn't know you were doing this. Oh, I'm doing this too. Oh, you know, we have to be, I think we have to be coordinated with
to keep the story straight.
Yeah. Well, and to make sure that we're all saying the same thing.
Right.
And that the CEOs are all saying the same thing.
Right. Yeah. I think the resistance that I have felt is from people that, yes, they want to do it, but they don't understand that doing it right can be easy, just with getting the attorneys on board, having, I mean, we all know that, for example, compensation. I want to come in and pay you top dollar for because I know what you're going to be facing, and I want you to be happy. I want to make sure our suppliers are happy. So compensation, okay, your cost is negligent. So it could look like we're paying you for specimens. So let's talk about it correctly. Mm-hmm. We all know that, yes, that's what we're doing.
Processing and time. And
exactly.
Yeah.
So yes, I am paying you, but how we're talking about it out there in the public square.
Are the other Planned Parenthoods doing this through research, or are they just doing it as a standalone contract?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Because even though we're doing it through research, if it comes up that someone else is just doing it as a business sort of venture, it's a different spin on it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So how could you imagine that being handled if that is...
We'd have to, that's where, I mean, I'd have to talk to Deb and see who else was involved, and get us all together. I think Deb could probably spearhead something, so it'd sort of be on the tail end of your conversations where you actually have contracts in place.
Oh, are you talking about Deb Nicotola or Deb Vanderhey?
Okay.
Deb Nicotola, because, so I feel like she has said before that they decided at National that research was overkill for tissue procurement because it's not really research, it's just collecting tissue,
so
there's no study.
Putting it under the research gives us a little bit of a little overhang sort of over the whole thing.
It makes it look better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, publicly, I think it makes a lot more sense for it to be in the research vein than as a...
Right, it's how we talk about it. Yeah,
it's how we talk about it. So even though they don't want to do it, and I may need to call research and Deb and just kind of shake this out, because I do want the other Planned Parenthoods, I want us all to be making the same decision. So if we all decide that we're going to do it outside of research, then we do it outside of research. But if we all decide we're going to do it under research, that we have a different path, that we know that we're all registering and doing the same thing. Again, it's just that cohesive bond.
So you really think there should almost be a national policy and protocol for how Planned Parenthood affiliates do tissue procurement?
You can't, just because we're all so different.
Oh.
But
mm-hmm.
We have to know who else is doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you have someone in a really anti-state that's going to be doing this for you, they're probably going to get caught.
How confident are you with your attorneys, the work that you've seen? They're building many layers so that they are making it difficult.
He's got it figured out, that he knows that even if... Because we talked to him in the beginning, we were like, we don't want to get called on selling beetle parts across.
Neither do we.
You know what I mean? Like, no one wants to get...
Right, so how do we protect ourselves from...
So how do we protect ourselves from that?
And you feel confident that they're building those layers and...
I'm confident that our legal will make sure that we are not put in that situation.
Was that crack? Was that just the little bits of the skull?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to... I'm just missing one leg. A foot.
That's the heart.
I think so, right?
Yeah.
Here's the heart.
Everyone should get in on it.
My fingers will smush it if I try to...
pick it up.
The heart is right there.
The heart over there.
So would you call that intact?
These are intact kidneys, okay. Yes. If somebody needed...
Because if I looked at that, I'd be like, that's good to go.
Oh, yeah.
I said 21.
Yeah. Yeah.
5 stars.
There was like 3 or 4 samples we could have taken out of the 11-6, so that would
Excellent.
Be, you know, if we were doing like, you know, 50 to 75 per specimen, that would be like 200, 300, right? And we'd be comfortable with that. But like, so it's like stuff like this, like we don't want to be like just a flat fee of like 200 and then... Yeah, it's like
no, and you know, the I think that
I think the per item thing works a little better just because we can see how much we can get out of it. So what do people, do they want brain? What do they do with
brain? Yeah, no, so brain, what you can do is with brain, they...
Do people do stuff with eyeballs?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Although eyeballs, they generally want more developed than this. And the cowl. There was brain in here. They got blasted out with the water.
Well, you know, a lot of times, especially with the second tries, is we won't even put water because it's so big. You can just put your hand in there and pick out
the
parts.
Right, just pick it up.
So I don't think they would be as war torn.
Yeah, war torn. Oh dear.
Well, here's some organs for you. They're all attached. Here's the stomach. Oops, sorry, they both of you. Can we? Heart. It's the stomach, a heart, a kidney, and adrenal. I don't know what else is in there.
Tiny.
Arms. I don't see the legs. Did you see any legs?
I didn't really look, but...
Oh, there you go.
Yep. We got all of them right
and
there.
Another boy!